Right, folks, welcome back to the MCM Outdoor Show. Just arrived in the car park at Red Screes, opposite the Kirkstone Pass Inn, and I'm waiting for a special guest that you've never seen before, Hosky, and Matt. We're going to do a wild camp atop Red Screes. A little bit different for me. I'm well out of my comfort zone because we've got a tiny 35 litre rucksack, taking an old Vango Helium 100 superlight tent and a hip flask as opposed to the usual bottle of red and a load of craft beer. So I've just got here, it's about 12:30 and we're waiting for Hosky to arrive. Weather's going to be okay. It's going to be a special 2-episode video because when I get down tomorrow, I'm going back to Boots in Windermere and the Walsh Meister's heading up. Hope you enjoy this one. Give us a thumbs up if you like it. And let's see how I fare with a lightweight backpack.
Good afternoon.
Is that cut short?
Yeah. I'm going to sort my stuff out.
Right.
Come on.
So we're here. Lightweight wild camp with Hosky, Matt. A few pints. Well, we had 3 to be specific. And we're just going to go and make the final adjustments to our gear situation. Let's stick the camera in Hosky's boot.
You've got this wrong with you. You look good. Child,
what? What's all this stuff?
Whiskey. In my.
What's that?
Water. Step aside.
What else have we got?
Got my toothpaste from the morning. Hat.
Yeah. What new stuff have we got? Alp kit stuff. Where is it?
It's in the front.
Right.
My favourite outdoor T-shirt.
Excellent.
New bag. The halogen 33 on test.
Very good.
Yeah.
Great.
Handles front and rear.
Excellent. Yeah. It's looking very organised.
Yeah, just need to put it all in there.
Right.
I'm on it.
Continue. So here we go. Matt's got a vintage Caramore pack, which I gave him years ago when Caramore was made in the UK. Very good. I've got my Fjallraven. Tiny. Coat strap to the side. Few beers in there and we're heading up somewhere. Red Screes, gonna camp somewhere on the ledges over there. Right, we just stopped because Matt, the personal trainer, needs a break, so we're gonna let him to get his breath back. As you can see, he's carrying a bit of excess weight.
Whether to take my little thing off or not?
I would. I'm going to brave it out. It's my weight loss.
You sweat it out. 3 layers.
Three layers.
Let's look over the top there.
Put them on and then take it off.
I had shorts on and you said, because you're a bell end, take your shorts off. I always know I'm right.
It's because the ticks. So, here we are on the summit of Red Screes again, which you've seen on numerous other videos, albeit not with the modelling cast of the Fjallraven Winter 2018 catalogue. So, yeah, stunning views over to Helvellyn, Brothers Water, Great Gable, the Scarfell Group. We're going to get a cup of tea on the go, and then when the crowds have died down a bit, decide where we're going to camp for the evening.
And we're a go.
Did you try the width on them first before you bought it?
No.
Because I find the pot stands on mine, they're not wide apart enough.
No, I know what you mean. I need some tissue to kind of get to the grabbing phase so I don't burn the...
You're fine once you've turned the gas off. The handles cool down a lot quicker than the body. It's a good little stove, that. Get
that. It didn't cost, it was only like 20 quid.
So, the good thing about this pack is, which I've showed you, a little sneak on a couple of videos is the side spoke, side access into your pack, so you don't have to go rooting around in the top pocket. You just got this little pull down zip, and then we can get out our gas cartridge and our cooking gear just to make ourselves a quick brew here on the summit without having to go into everything. We get access to our whole pack. It's very handy and it's a good feature.
So this is Christopher's seventh time moving the tent. He's inspected every meter section of the summit until he's found one which is perfectly level. There was a blade of grass near his face on the last one, so he's had to move. Is this the right one, Chris?
I don't know. I really don't know.
What's happening now? Where are you moving to?
I think here.
You tried lying down first.
He's moved 0.6 of a millimetre to the right.
That'll make a bit of a difference, that.
I reckon so.
There's a bloody rock under that.
Where's your tent bag?
Obviously,
do that so that in the morning you can actually wake up in my
obviously camp. you won't be able to see my camp because it's so well camouflaged. But there we go. That's my morning view.
So in the cellar today we have the following, kindly provided by Ian from the Coniston Brewery, a nice can so we can stamp on it and make it a little bit smaller when we're packing up. The classic Bluebird award-winning bitter, also once again kindly provided by Ian from Coniston, an ass rye. Ass rye. I'm sorry. It's nice. I'll tell you a bit more about it when we open it. Black Betty IPA, about 3 pints, and this nectar by Northern Monk. Hosky, what's on the menu?
Chicken casserole with potatoes and mixed vegetables.
Excellent.
Quite
have you got a nice red wine vinaigrette to go with it?
No, just some whiskey and some of your rice.
Excellent. How's it going, Cottle?
So far so good. We've got lots of raw chicken.
Yeah.
Now being cooked.
Yeah.
Once that's cooked through, keeping it moving so it doesn't stick.
Right.
Spices going in.
Yep.
And then the pasty stuff.
Lovely.
It'll be very nice, that.
Have you got your meths on hand to top up if required?
Well, remember the rule, we don't top up unless you're absolutely certain the flame's out or you set your whole body on fire.
Always remember, everybody, never play with fire. Dangerous.
It's hot.
Yes, you might bet. Always ask an adult. Right, here we go. We've got a can of Bluebird, the infamous Bluebird bitter, which has kindly been provided by Ian Bradley from the Coniston Brewing Company. Thanks very much, Ian. It's very much appreciated. It's a lovely, lovely craft beer. And this is what it says. If you don't know this, well, I'd be pretty surprised. A canned version of the cask beer that won the highest award of Supreme Champion Beer of Britain at the Great British Beer Festival in 98. Bluebird Bitter is an easy drinking craft beer with Maris Otter malts, Challenger hops and Mountain Water. The best of Britain is here in a can. It's 3.6% and there's obviously the canned version. Just a shout out as well to Elise Higham, who's hooked us up with this one. We've got quite a few which we're going to spread over the next couple of camps, but here's the initial open with the backdrop of the Scarfell range in the Lake District. What better place to enjoy the beer? It's gone up everywhere. Here we go. I'm trying to do it one-handed. The unmistakable smell. It's smooth, very, very easy drinking. Lovely hops, but that's lovely. It's just really easy drinking. Probably get away with it as a session beer as well. 3.6%. I would definitely be giving it the 8.5, 9 out of 10. I could easily just neck that entire can, but it's brilliant. Coniston Blue Bear Bitter. And again, thanks very much, Ian. Very much appreciated and very kind. If you've been to Coniston, go to the Black Bull Inn and check out Bluebird or lots of others. It's a brilliant post Coniston Old Man watering hole. Check it out. Right, look at that. Absolutely spectacular sunset. I'm gonna get some time lapse. Right, as usual, no trace left. Wild camp night one done. Back to base. So there we go, back to base. What time is it, anyone? 0800 hours, time check. I'm meeting Walsh here at 10:30, sweating, get some layers off, go to Windermere and freshen up. Over and out for part one.